Mr. Aubrey de Grey, you are Chief Science Officer and co-founder of Sense Research Foundations. You want to abandon death. Why?
Well, to say that I want to abandon death is rather a distortion of what we do. We are a biomedical research charity, and we are working to develop medicines that will alleviate and postpone the diseases and disabilities of old age. So, of course, at the moment, we know that aging causes more death than anything else, but we are not working on every cause of death.
So aging is a kind of illness then?
I think it's fair to say that aging is a medical condition. Whether you call it a disease is really a matter of terminology, but certainly it is potentially amenable to medical intervention.
Living for, 100 of years, 1,000 of years, causes a lot of social and economic problems. How to cope with that?
We have actually no idea whether extending lifespan as a side effect of keeping people healthy will actually cause any social problems. We have to remember, first of all, that any effects that we would have as a result of keeping people from getting Alzheimer's or cancer or diabetes and so on, those effects would have a very slow impact on demography. We would not have any 200-year-old people for at least another 100 years, for example. Right? And a lot happens in 100 years. So I have no idea whether there will actually be any social consequences.
If investors want to invest in your research, how can they invest?
Some of the technologies that we feel are going to be necessary to postpone aging are already well enough advanced that it makes sense to take them into the private sector. Especially stem cell therapy is a very big deal now in the biotech industry. Many of the technologies that we at Sense Research Foundation are working on are at a much earlier stage, and that's why we're a charity, a 501c3 non-profit. But as we progress, we will be able increasingly to move those things into the private sector. In the meantime, I think that the right way for investors to proceed is to get involved with our network, perhaps also, of course, to donate, but certainly to get involved with the network of scientists and researchers and indeed other people who are at the cutting edge of the development of these technologies so that they can invest appropriately as time goes on.
Mr. Gray, thank you for the talk.